Welcome to Centers. This is for art. My name is Miss Kaylin, and today I have a super fun activity planned. I hope you're just excited as I am. So what we're going to do is we're going to draw how music makes us feel. Music can make everyone feel a different way, whether it's a happy, sad song. It can make anyone feel any type of way, depending on the person. So I'm going to show you guys one of my favorite songs and how my favorite song makes me feel. And I want you guys at home to show me how it made you feel. So let me show you how this song made me feel. I'm also going to play the song for you so you guys can draw at home and draw out how that song makes you feel. So all you're going to need for this activity is going to be a piece of paper, and you're going to need some markers, colored pencils, crayons, anything you want to put on your piece of paper.
I got this feeling inside my bones. It goes electric, baby, when I turn it on. All through my city, all through my home. We're flying up, no ceiling when we in the zone. I got that sunshine in my pocket, got that good soul in my feet, feel that hot blood in my body, it drops. Ooh, I can't take my eyes off of it, not even so phenomenally. Come on, rock on, baby, rock it, so don't stop.
Okay, friends, that was it for today. I hope you guys had so much fun with me. And I'm also going to show you my final drawing of how that song made me feel. And I want to see all of your drawings so I can see how that song made you feel. So what I drew was a sun. I said sunshine. I drew some clouds because it's a nice day out. I drew some hearts and love and dancing and singing. These are some music notes. I really like that song. It makes me feel really happy. It makes me feel love. And I just want to know how that song made you feel. So I hope you guys, I want to thank you guys all for joining me. I hope you had an amazing time. And now we're going to go to Miss Jamie.
Hi, friends. Today in writing, we will be doing something similar to what we did previously. Today, we will be drawing birthday baskets for a friend or a family member. This is similar to what Cecilia did in Birthday Basket for Tia, where she, with the help of her mom, made a birthday basket for her great aunt. And I remember it was a big surprise, and her aunt was really satisfied with her gift. So today, we're going to play make-believe that is the birthday of someone very special in our lives, and we get to choose what goes in their surprise birthday basket. So as you can see, I started off drawing and decorating my basket. For today's activity, all you really need is a piece of paper and a few writing utensils. So I chose to draw my basket with the color yellow because that is my dad's favorite color. And today I'm going to be making a birthday basket for my dad. So maybe you want to think about what color you're going to make your family member's birthday basket. Is it a pattern they like? Is it a color they like? So who are you going to draw your birthday basket for? As I said, I will be making a basket full of gifts for my dad. Is the person you're making your basket for a friend or a family member? What kind of items do you think they would like in their basket? So once you get that squared away, I want you to think of the first item you want to add to your friend or family member's basket. Personally, I know that my dad, he really likes to read. Specifically, he likes to read mystery novels and reads every night before he goes to bed. So I'm going to add a detective book to his basket. I'm going to draw the front cover, the back cover, and I'm going to add a magnifying glass on the front cover so that he knows it's a mystery book. I remember in Birthday Basket for Tia, Tia also received a book in her basket. So what is the first thing that you added to your family member's surprise birthday basket? Interesting. Yeah. So I want my birthday basket to show my dad that I really care about him. So I'm going to add some meaningful items to his basket. I think I'm going to add a picture of the two of us So this is a picture of us that was taken on vacation at the beach. We don't get to go to the beach very often, but when we do, it's a really meaningful and special day to us. And I really want to memorialize that day so that he can remember it forever. Are you going to add personalized items to your family's gift basket? Perhaps you can add a drawing that you made of the two of you together, or maybe a photograph that somebody took of the two of you together. Either way, I'm sure that your family member will really appreciate all the gifts that are included in their basket. So I also want to add a gift in my dad's basket that he and I can do together, can participate together in. So I think that I'm going to add a basketball to his birthday basket. Sometimes on the weekend, my dad and I, we like to go to the local basketball court and shoot a few hoops. Is there anything that you and your family members like to do together that perhaps you could add in their basket? Sometimes it's a really good gift to just be able to spend time together. So if you add a gift such as a basketball, which is something that you guys can participate with together, that'll add some more time for you guys to spend. So I think the last item that I'm going to add is a sort of treat for my dad. Now his doctor tells him that he's not allowed to have a lot of soda, but he doesn't say he's not allowed to have any soda. So I'm going to add one bottle of Mountain Dew because that is his absolute favorite treat. He can't have it a lot, but when he does, he really appreciates it. I'm going to add a bottle of Mountain Dew because I know that is something that he really enjoys and he really likes. Is there a food or a drink that you think that your family member would really like? Maybe they really like pizza. You could get them a gift certificate, like a gift card to Pizza Hut or Domino's, or maybe your favorite restaurant you go to. Sometimes it's nice for our birthdays to receive stuff that we don't usually get all year round. It's like a special treat. All right. So now when you are done with your basket, I encourage you to share and compare with your classmates what you put in your basket compared to what they put in their baskets for their family members. Then perhaps you can ask a teacher or a family member to help you label your items. I'm going to do that really quickly. I'm going to put that I added a book, a picture, a basketball, and Mountain Dew. Awesome. I really hope that I'll be able to get the chance to see your birthday baskets that you designed for your family members. And I encourage you to show the family member that you designed the birthday basket for what you put in their basket. Now I'm going to hand you off to Miss Galise so you can share what you did in Jumpstart today. And thank you so much for joining me today.
Hi, friends, and welcome to Sharing and Goodbye. This is the time where we talk about our favorite part of the session today and we wrap up for the day. So I know we did a lot of things today. We got to read Birthday Basket for Tia one more time with Miss Hannah. After that, we went to Let's Find Out About It, and we learned about even more instruments. So now we know about string instruments, percussion instruments, wind instruments, and we can even become musicians and use our body as an instrument and use regular household items as an instrument as well. After Let's Find Out About It, we went to Centers. I know we had art and writing today, and I'm so excited to hear about what your favorite part of Centers was. That is why we're here. That's what I want to hear. And so, after we finish with Sharing and Goodbye, I want you to find a friend, a family member, a teacher, anyone who is near you, and I want you to share with them what your favorite part of Center was today. And if they were a part of Jumpstart session with you, then I want you to use your listening ears and listen to their favorite part of Center as well. All right, friends? So next time we meet, I will have a brand new book. We will be reading The Little Red Hen Makes a Pizza. That is such a fun book to read, and we get to see such a delicious pizza. It looks so good. So I cannot wait to bring that to you, friends. All right, so now it's time to sing our goodbye song. Hopefully you remember it. If not, that is okay. Just use your listening ears so you will learn it eventually. All right, are you ready to sing, friends? Let me see some thumbs up. Okay. So long, farewell to you, my friends. Goodbye for now until we meet again. It's been great to play and sing together at Jumpstart, and now it's time to say goodbye. All right, friends, don't forget to share what your favorite part of session was and to use your listening ears and hear what your friend's favorite part of session was. And don't forget, also, we will be reading Little Red Hen Makes a Pizza next time in our Jumpstart session. I'll see you later, friends, and thank you for watching. Goodbye.